All right. Welcome to the stream, everyone. All right. Welcome to the stream, everyone. All right. There we go. All right. Whew. Man, you know, here's the thing, right? You try to do something, and you seem to run into every possible technical issue you can imagine. All right. Let's see here. Okay, so obviously it's been a while since I've been in the cockpit. There was no stream last week because, I didn't have air conditioning. And, well, I live in a part of the country where you really need air conditioning. So we'll just leave it at that. Let's see here. Let me go take care of that dog real quick. Okay, I'm back. All right, so let's start with getting our position in the system. Galaxy. All right, so we're currently sitting in Rohini, I guess. And we are, I think we're about 14,000 light years from Colonia. So we're just past the quarter point. There's just to kind of show you how far we are from Sol. 7,600 light years from Sol. All right. One last thing, let's make sure I punch in my next coordinate. I'll be right back. All right. Plot a course. Yep, that's a neutron star, about 200 light years. All right, let's make sure everything is good before we leave. Okay, there shouldn't be anything I need to sell. Good. Let's make sure. Fueled, repaired. Let's look at our advanced maintenance. Paint's a little worn, but that's okay. We'll live with that. All right. Let's get out of here. I was hoping I remember how to fly this thing. Oh, we're on a planet. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, we're not on a planet, we're just orbiting a planet. Okay. All right, first jump of the stream. Let's hit it. Oh, frameshift drive locked. Well, hopefully I don't crash my ship on the way. Here we go. Yeah, I've actually not been in the cockpit for a week. I wasn't kidding about being without air conditioning that long. And I didn't want to... My office is usually about 4 degrees warmer than the rest of the house. It was pretty bad. So, not doing any of that. Okay. All right. Let's see what we got. High Metal Content World, Rocky Bodies, a couple Gas Giants. You know what? Yeah, let's just go ahead and just find these. There aren't that many. And there's a chance they might be inhabitable. C. Patton Nick. Last three Gas Giant. Very blue, but that might have something to do with the neutron star in this system. Casts a beautiful blue aura around everything. Okay. Where's that last star system, our little planet? Where are you at? Where the hell are you? Okay, there's a couple of them. You know what? Maybe they're... I bet they're around those Gas Giants. That's a safe bet, right? No. Okay, I guess we need to start looking outside the rings, the orbital rings. Okay, what's going on here? Ah, there they are. Yeah, looks like there's just these two here. Alright, system map. Let's see. Is anybody worth scanning? Yeah. Gas Giants. Yeah, I bet these are going to be too far from the sun. Well, Neutron Star's got a pretty... The habitable zone's pretty far. Not yet mapped. Not yet mapped. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I kind of figured. All right. All right. Let's see if I remember how to pull off this maneuver. Gotcha. All right, here we go. Light-year jump. Inside. much here. Just a couple stars. Took a while. Alright, let me get my next waypoint. Okay. So it looks like we're going to be on the Neutron Highway for a while. So let me take a look at my... Yeah. Frameshift drive usually takes about 1% damage per... boost, I guess. I mean, the FSD is operating beyond safety measures, so it's kind of to be expected. How are we getting on fuel? Yeah, we're getting on fuel. I'm doing the normal thing of just... Once I get to halfway, I'll start looking for a star to fuel at. Hopefully, these neutron star systems also have a scoopable star in there. Ooh, 13 bodies. All right, let's see if there's anything worth looking at. Metal. High metal content. High metal content. Rocky Ice World. I don't know. 13 of them. I don't know how useful that's going to be. Though, there's a chance... Could be habitable, so high metal contents can, so we'll just... Ooh, what do we have here? Nitrogen atmosphere, looks promising. Ooh, now that one looks very promising. Carbon dioxide-based atmosphere. Alright. What do we got here? You know what? I'm glad I took the time to do this. Some of these planets look pretty promising. Ooh, what kind of star are you? Ah, yes! You're an M-class star, so I can actually refuel from you. Good. Ooh, I don't know. Some of these planets are looking pretty promising. And I noticed somebody already mapped one, so that's a good sign in and of itself. All right. Another one that looks promising. Whenever you see, like, you can kind of tell there's like an atmosphere, like, ring around it. Those are typically the ones you want to go for. Okay. Let's see what we got here. See that one, it has an atmosphere, but you can tell that the The terrain's very dark. Which could indicate that it's very hot. Same with this one. Yeah, you can actually see, like, it looks like volcanic activity on it. Not a good candidate. Okay, what is going on with my... Alright, there we go. My joystick wasn't on an even surface. Alright. Alright, let's take a look at the system. What do we got here? Okay, not yet mapped. Not yet mapped. Not yet mapped. Okay, I kind of had a feeling. Oh, that third one from the second star looks promising. That one, nope. Really? Huh. That looks like it would be terraformable. You have not yet mapped this planet. You have not yet mapped this planet. You have not yet mapped. You have not mapped this planet. Huh. That's so weird. Like, look at that planet. It looks... Wow. No volcanism, carbon dioxide. I don't know. Maybe it's got to do with the atmosphere composition. You want something with high nitrogen. I think that's where it's disqualified. Okay, well. All right. Ooh. Well, I can at least fly by and get some fuel. Alright. Light seconds. That's doable. Once I can get some speed up. Actually, while I'm doing that, let me plug in my next coordinate. Okay. Alright. Oops, that's not what I wanted. There we go. What are we looking at here? 17 minutes. Oh. Alright, I got a decision to make. I think I'm good. I'm gonna hold out for a closer star. And like, as I've said, if, you know, it's not a big deal if I have to go off the beaten path a little bit to get fuel, I'll be okay. Hope I don't regret this decision. Oh well. Alright, let's see. Big prize, big prize, big prize. Huh. Well, this one's got a star that's twice as far away. Okay. Come on. I always get, like, knocked out of the stream. All right. All right. Next waypoint. For some reason, my 3D star map, because the thing you're looking at is technically a 3D star map, it's just you're only seeing it in 2D. For some reason, that kept like panning down. Not sure why it was doing that. I should have just picked different star system. All right. I'm gonna play the odds and see if I can get a closer system. I'm running a little low on fuel, but I should be fine. See what we got here. Lots of high metal content worlds, some gas giants. Well, we already know high metal content's usually a good way to go. Though, I have a feeling there's going to be less of a chance for them to be habitable because they're orbiting a gas giant, but you never know. Oh, are these just rocky bodies? Oh, damn, they're just rocky bodies. Yeah, these are just rocky bodies. Oh, I don't think there's going to be anything worthwhile. Well, someone went through and mapped these. Though they might have just done that for prestige reasons. But you never know.
system scan complete.
All right. I doubt there'll be anything interesting, but we'll get a little money out of it. Regardless. All right, what do we got here? You've not yet mapped this planet. You've not yet mapped this planet. Not yet. Yeah, I understand there's like a third-party add-on I could be using that would tell me immediately if any of these planets are worth scanning, but I don't know. It's hard with the VR headset. Okay. All right. All right, let's get our next waypoint and then I'm gonna go grab some fuel after that. All right. Wow, that's only 131 light years away. Interesting. I wonder. Let's see here. Star class, here we go. Let's see here. Let's take that off. Actually. Oh, be a fine girl, kiss me. All right. Think. I think you're a good candidate. Might as well, right? Yeah, and that'll take us right to a scoopable star, and then we'll be one standard jump away from the rest of the highway. I've actually never got a low fuel indicator. I think it's about 20% you start getting like the low fuel indicator. There we go. So this is supposed to fill my tank in 30 seconds, so let's see. Okay, we're at maximum fuel. Maximum fuel scoopage. Oh yeah, this thing's going pretty fast. There we go. All right. Let's back away from the star, scan the system real quick. See if there's anything worth looking at. Ooh, a water world. Hello. I just randomly picked this one. Lucky me. Well, all right. Looks like we got a planet to scan. Let's see here. Oh, and look, it's the first one on my radar, too. How about that? Ooh, now that's a pretty water world. Yeah, someone's already been here. That's fine. So Is there anything else out here? Nope. Okay, good. Metal content world. Looks like another carbon dioxide based atmosphere. I don't know if you're going to be able to do much with that from a terraforming standpoint. Sulfur dioxide, maybe. Ah, the mail must be here. All right. Okay, so we already know the water world. That's a no-brainer. Oh, wow, look at these planets. Looking pretty promising. Let's see. Okay, not yet mapped. Not yet mapped. Not yet mapped. Oh, shit. This one is... it's carbon dioxide atmosphere. That's interesting. And it's still a candidate for terraforming. Oh! Holy shit! It's not only a water world, but it's also a water world that's a candidate for terraforming. That's going to bring in some nice money. And finally, this guy. Okay. So, what are we looking at? We're looking at planet 4 and 5. Okay. Which one's closer? Okay. Well, look at that. I picked the right system to jump to on my fuel stop. How about that? I was in such a hurry to get the stream, I kind of lost track of time after work, that I forgot to bring myself a drink. Might have to go grab one. Oh, wow, we're actually at 95% frameshift drive integrity. Okay. I'm trying to remember what the threshold is. I think it's like less than 80 and it starts to malfunction. So that's a thing you got to worry about. But thankfully, I've got plenty of auto field maintenance units. Ooh, that is a... That looks like a skull. I don't know what that nebula is called. But it looks like a skull. I'm just going to call it the Skull Nebula. Man, you cannot beat the view on this ship. Like, some people want to hate on the Asp Explorer, but it's good for what it is. I don't think I'd use this as a combat ship. I mean, it could be a combat ship, but it, for what it's worth, like, as an exploration ship, it's damn good at it. What it does. All right, let's see where these land. We're a 6 par. I'm so glad I took the time to upgrade. Oh, yeah, look at that. Boom. All right. And I think if we put one here and maybe one right here, that should do it. Oh, yeah, we got it. Got our efficiency bonus. Let's go to number 5. Planet 5. Anarchy Waterworld. Reminds me of the movie Waterworld. Which, yeah, a lot of people give that movie a lot of crap because it was so overhyped, over budget. But I don't know. I still like it. That and The Postman. Anyone in the chat ever seen The Postman? I really like that movie. It's probably the only movie I've seen that makes the United States Postal Service look badass as hell. And if I remember correctly, I believe it was filmed in Oregon. Or it was supposed to take place in Oregon. Which, I had planned to go to Oregon this year, but, yeah. Those plans have been put on hold and delayed a little bit, if you would. But I'll make it out there sometime. I have been to the West Coast. I've been to San Francisco. I went to San Francisco in 2014. Which even then, even in 2014, that place was super expensive. I remember my hotel, right next to my hotel, I stayed at the King George. If anyone's familiar with San Francisco. And right next to it, or like maybe two stores down, there's a little diner, just like a regular, like, Americana-type diner. And, you know, I just bought a regular cheeseburger. Nothing fancy, just a regular diner cheeseburger and fries. And I paid, like, $20 for it. It's, like, ridiculous. So, things are ridiculously expensive there. I would not want to live there. I'd happily visit again. I had a great time there. Didn't get to see Alcatraz though, but because I was there for an event, there was a work event I was at. Loop of shame. I was running my yap. Running my yap, wasn't paying attention to my distance and throttle. There we go. Now that is a very nice looking planet. Look at that. So I wonder what constitutes a water world. Like, because our planet is like 70% water, I believe. Or 70% of our planet surface is covered by water, if I remember correctly. So, like, what percentage of, I mean, is there any landmass on a water world? Or is the landmass so insignificant that, you know, it barely counts? All right, let's see here. And I'll dump you right there. This is a pretty big planet, too. Well, good. Oh, look at that. Good job, Claudius Aurelius. First to discover it and first to map it. Good job. All right. I'll be right back. Okay. Ha, there it is. Ha, 12 light years away. Nice. All right, cool. Cool. Got a full tank of gas. Well, hydrogen. Well, I guess it's a gas. I can say it's a gas. I can say it's a gas. It's fine. It's gas, guys. It's all gas. Thank you. actually, after this jump, I need to see when our next pit stop is. This feels like it's taking longer than it should. Here we go. Just to give you guys a little insight, that's supposed to be a loading screen. What do we got? High Metal Content World. Ooh, Water World. Hello. Look at that. What's this? Oh. Okay, there's our high metal content world. Nitrogen atmosphere, pretty promising. Though I guess that doesn't really mean much. Oh wow, look at that water world. It's got a ring. You know what? I think it's time for a picture. I think it's picture time. I gotta get a picture with that water world. I mean, I'm gonna be there anyway. I might as well, right? Oh, for those of you watching on Twitch, I actually put a link to the photo album that I'm putting together. It's like, you'll see, it has an Imgur logo on it. It's pretty easy to figure out. There's also links to my Adara and EDSM profile, if any of you care about that stuff. Ooh. Oh, and it's terraformable. Hello. Good money. All right, let's see if your neighbor is... You have not mapped this world. Okay, so just you. Huh, cool. All right, well, this is pretty exciting. I don't think I've ever seen a water world with a ring before. That'll be nice. And it's terraformable, so I should be getting a nice chunk of change from this. Which, it's not like I'm hurting for money. I don't even know. Like, I'm trying to figure out the best way to communicate the distance that I'm going to be traveling for this whole journey. 65,000 light years. One way. Like, we're, like, 20,000 light years from the center of the galaxy, Sagittarius A. Like, if at Beagle Point, if I looked back and I had a telescope that was powerful enough, and I could, like, pick out Earth's light, that's 65,000 years in the past. Like, it's incredible, just the awesome distances. And I have no idea how long this is going to take me. Like I said, a previous stream, I'm not going to be doing all of it on stream. I'm going to be doing a lot throughout the week. I'm going to try to, like, spend an hour, like, you know, flying and all that. But wait a minute. You're a water world that orbits another planet? This is interesting. But yeah, I mean, just it makes my brain hurt a little bit. Oh, wow, look at that ring. That series of rings, that's wild looking. too fast. All right. Huh. Okay, well, that's going to hit the ring. Okay, I guess I'm going to try, like, real hard not to hit the ring. Yeah, that was just for the rings. Don't get too excited. Well, looks like there's a couple hot spots. Like, low-temperature diamonds, I think? I'm not really a miner. I don't know, like, all the good stuff that can be in these hot spots, but... Okay. I think we can just put you right there. Yeah, that should be fine. I need like 6% more. That should be enough. Alright. Alright, let's take some pictures. Got a little bit of a photo op going on here. Switch you. Ship. Let's turn off the orbital lines. Okay, orbital lines off. It's gonna go. Actually, let's try to get a little closer to these rings. I think that'd make a pretty cool shot. Here we go. Hide the HUD. And let's see here. We always take a couple shots. Turn those orbital rings back on. Oops. All right. All right. I think you were the only planet that was habitable, right? Okay, cool. Yeah, we didn't have any. Despite its neighbor looking really good. Yeah. Alright. Okay. That's a good, healthy 200 light years. Oh, right, I forgot to check when our next pit stop is. Okay. Yeah, I'm about 2,000 light years till our next stop. But once we reach that stop, we'll be halfway through the first leg of our journey. So that's something to celebrate. Doing module wise 93%. Okay. Okay, some gas giants, high metal content worlds, metal rich bodies, huh? Yeah, I'm not gonna worry about it. Oh wow, look at the sky. Whoa, this is wild. So I think dead ahead of us, we're staring at the center of the galaxy. It has to be. It's the brightest point in the sky. It's pretty wild stuff. Alright, 225 light years. Frameshift drive charging. Metal content, gas giant. Sure, why not? We might get lucky with these high metal content worlds. Though I haven't been very lucky on this round. Oh, must be a gas giant. Ooh, that looks promising. Sulfur dioxide. Oh, was that it? See, I've seen planets that look like that that have been terraformable, so... Ah, sadly you're not one of them. Okay, well, hey, at least we tried, right? The turbulence are a bit of a pain. Alright. Okay. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. So I'm thinking the 3D map is just recentering itself every time it updates. So, we're just going to have to deal with it. It doesn't look that bad. The only issue I have with it is it shows the part of the path that I took for the Bubble Nebula expedition. But you guys are pretty smart. You know which direction we're headed, so... And it might be kind of fun to kind of show you, like, in comparison, how far that expedition is compared to this one. I mean, we've already exceeded the range. Okay, we've just got to hold this position for a few more seconds. Wow, it feels satisfying watching that bar fill so high. So, and that's the one drawback with the Diamondback Explorer is you can't fit, like the largest scoop you can fit on, I think it's like a class 4. And so to put that in perspective, it'll take like a minute and 30 seconds to fully top off your tank. Rocky bodies. Wow, really? Just rocky bodies? I don't know. I'm not feeling too good about this place. Out of curiosity, has anyone else found this place yet? Ah, let me get that dog. Alright. Had to quiet the dog a little bit. Alright. Yeah, so it's 4 jumps to the next neutron star. And then from there, I think it's 7 jumps to the next neutron star. And then from there, we'll be, Once we make it past that 7 jump leg, we'll be at like the 50% mark, and then the next one after that is going to be our pit stop. Which will be nice. It'll give me a chance to patch up the ship. 9 orbital bodies, huh? Icy bodies, high metal content world. Yeah, these aren't looking too promising. It's a balance. You gotta strike a balance between scanning systems and jumping. Not that I'm in a hurry or anything, but I have a lot of space to cover. But But we should be able to make it to the pit stop before the end of the stream, unless I run into some kind of, like, money... Whoa. Okay. Unless I run into some kind of, like, jackpot system that's got, like, 8 terraformable planets. I think we'll be okay. We clear this star. And for those of you that don't know that trick, once the star goes from red to yellow on your display, on your radar, you can jump without fear of your ship overheating. Because as your frameshift drive is charging, it'll build up heat. And if you're too close to a star, you'll actually overheat. Fry a bunch of your components, which isn't fun. I know, I've done it a few times. Alright, what do we got? Oh. Okay. Just one neutron star. Cool. I just noticed we have 2 people watching now. Hello. If you're just tuning in, I'm on my way to Colonia on part of an epic expedition to Beagle Point. I think I'm about... Let's see. 22,000 light years from Seoul to Colonia. I'm almost halfway there-ish. I would say about maybe 45% of the way. So, what? Like 10,000 light years from Seoul, I think? Is my math right? I don't know. Something like that. Ooh, I think this is the long haul, like the 7 jump. Oh no, 2 jumps. System scan complete. Huh. Must be 4 stars in this system, and not a whole lot else. Alright. Let's kinda go down. Let's see, what do we got? I'm just curious. Whoa. Okay, yeah, 4 stars. Yeah, I thought, figured as much. Oh wow. Okay, I'm leaving my inner Orion Spur, and I'm actually going to enter a new sector of the galaxy. Region of the galaxy. There we go. Region. I think there's like 42 regions. I think I'll show you what I'll show you what I'm talking about in a minute. Oh yeah, I'm gonna be finding a lot of new stuff here. Here, let me show you. Look at the codex. Okay. So, here's Inner Orion Spur. That's where the Sol system is, and this is where we just moved. So, all your discoveries are region specific, even if it's the same thing. So you notice we just found a type L star. You know what? Let's just kind of just scan all these. Ooh, hello, what do we have here? Gas giant. Yeah, see? Standard gas giant discovered, codex updated. So. So all these, like, common types of planets, because I've never been to this sector before, they're all new to the codex. So. Icy body. Don't really earn any money for discoveries through the codex. It's kind of like stamp collecting, I guess. Yeah, non-terraformable. But what's really nice is, when you're in a new region and you find a terraformable planet, it'll pop up for the first time you discover it, so you'll kind of know immediately. Of course, it only works the one time. After that, yeah. Not very helpful. Right, let's see if anything's worth looking at. Further examination. Let's see. This isn't very promising. A lot of the... Yeah. Like, that looks like an ice body, and ice bodies can never be terraformed. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And if it's that close to the star, the rest of them, you just forget it. But that'll get some stuff on my codex checked off. Forgot to see how many jumps I had left. I think it's like two. Oh, never mind. Neutron star. Yep. This is it. Interesting that it can give me a codex entry for that. Okay, so my guess is there's another star somewhere. Yep, there it is. Usually these asteroid clusters are going to be around a star. Ooh, what's this? Non-terraformable. Yeah, whatever. It's a lot of rocks. All right. Let's see. Actually, I think we already know it's not going to be terraformable. Yep. Ooh, but 19 geological sites. That's pretty cool. In that next waypoint. It's gonna be like two jumps. Yeah, two jumps. Frameshift drive charging. Oh wow, look at that star field. Beautiful. Oh wow, look at that nebula. High metal content. Oh, what the hell? Yeah, I wish it would just tell you up front when you scan a planet whether it's terraformable, but guess it doesn't matter once you've already scanned it. You can look at it in the system map. But I also wish there was some kind of like icon or something on the... I don't know. It'll just make things a little faster. Because you can kind of eyeball it, but even then, I've been wrong so many times. Thinking, oh, that planet looks like it's terraformable. No, it's not. Alright. Texas Zidiot? Okay. Alright. Let's see what we got here. We have... Oh, none of these look promising. Oh! What? this body is a candidate for terraforming. I wouldn't have guessed. It doesn't look like it would be. Okay, not map this. Okay. All right. Cool. Well, we got one planet here that we can terraform. That's good. Not yet mapped it. Not yet mapped. Like that, I would never have guessed that planet was a candidate. I'm not... I don't know. But hey, as long as the computer says it's habitable, that means the data I sell will be worth a lot, so a lot more. Oh, crap, 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 crap. Oh, no, not the loop of shame. No, anything but the loop of shame. Was not paying attention. Oh, I'm out of practice. That's what happens when you haven't played the game in a week. You start, like, making all these little mistakes. Yeah, well. It's not a big deal. Just damages my pride every time it happens. See where they land. It's a par six. I'll be surprised if I get it in one go like this. Okay, you know what? I need to believe in my updated scanner more. And I'm the first person to scan it, I'm pretty sure. So I'll get my name on it. How about that? All right. All right. Wow, look at those stars. System scan complete. Okay. I wonder. Now you got me curious. Our orbital lines. I'm seeing if... Okay, they're both M class. Oh, excuse me. Throat's a little dry. One day I'll learn how to go with the spin of the cone. All right. Where are we at? All right. 250, that's like two jumps. Not too worried about that. I mean, when you have a jump range of 253.99 light years. Oh, how's my module health doing? Okay. I'm in the 80s on the frameshift drive. I think I'll be okay. I think I'll be all right. I haven't even looked to see what kind of situation I can't even talk today. I haven't looked to see what kind of services are available at the pit stop. Ooh, 29. Alright. Huh. Oh wow, look at that starfield. That is wild. Icy bodies. Gas giants. None of those are terraformable. And I have a feeling I'm going to get plenty of opportunities to scan ice bodies. Not too worried about that. Engage. Come on, get in there. Get in there. There we go. Wow, look at that star field. It is awesome looking. All right. Wow, so some of the, just the backdrops in this place, it's incredible. All right. All right, I'll be right back. Okay. Neutron star, 37. What? Okay. Don't know how that's gonna work. We're gonna find out. Yeah, two jumps. That seems about right. I bet this next one's gonna be a neutron star. Because I told my computer to basically go to any, plot a course through any star system I haven't been to before, which is pretty much all of them. But it's also taking into account my neutron stars, because apparently it's smart enough to do that. Which is apparently something that the game didn't do at one point. Whoa! Look at this! We're in like a field of stars. This is amazing. Alright, what do we got? I see bodies. Ooh, Waterworld. Hello. Yes, please, sign me up for Waterworld. I don't think I've discovered a water world in this region of space before. Okay. I kind of love that it's making a big deal about a rocky ice planet. It's like there's so many, they're dime a dozen. And that's with inflation. I know, bad dad joke. I'll stop. Something good in here. Non-terraformable rocky body, thanks. Ooh, high metal content world. Nitrogen atmosphere? I didn't bother looking at the temperature. That looks promising. It looks like a blue marble. Typically, your terraformable planets are going to look like blue marbles. Unless they're not. Oh, there's my buddy, Commander Validating. He gets around a lot. All right. Where's the water world? Ah, there's the water world. Yeah. Terraformable discovered. Yes. All right, first things first. Let's grab some... Go ahead and boost our FSD. Eh, safety limits. Whatever. Engineers, what do they know? Yeah. Alright. What do these engineers know? Safety limits, please. Alright. Let's see what we got here. Okay, Waterworld. Good. Let's see if its buddy is... Not a candidate for terraforming, oddly enough. But it looks like it could be. All right, and these just look like a bunch of boring ice planets. Yeah, icy rock world. Yeah, we're not going to worry about those. Really, only one planet? Hmm. Well, whatever. I've got like I think in total I have about less than a dozen jumps to my destination. And actually we should get there right before the stream ends, I think, because I usually run this thing for about 2 hours. So oh, crap. I need, like, a swear jar, but, like, for doing the loop of shame. It's like every time I do the loop of shame, like, donate a dollar to charity or something. Keep getting distracted by that star field. It's so bright. Love it. And each one of those is a system I could go to. Just keep that in mind. Not just a pretty background. You can go to all those stars. There might not be anything there, but you can go to them. All right. Par 7. Alright. Getting there. Just past the 50% mark. Ah, I had some overlap. Yeah. Hate it when that happens. You know, let me just shoot one right here. There we go. That might be enough. We'll see. Done. I mean, hey, as long as you get that efficiency bonus at the end, doesn't matter. Actually, I need to look up how much that efficiency bonus nets you. Because I know if you're the first to discover a planet, you get an extra, like, 50% commission. And I want to say if you're the first to map a planet, you get an extra 50% commission on the mapping portion of that payout, I think. I don't know what the efficiency bonus nets you. I just know you get more money. Okay, fine. One metal content world. Let's see where you are, my little friend. Let's see here. You're probably... Nope. Probably, if you're not along this orbital path, oh, there you are. Ooh, there's a couple. Watch that be a candidate for terraforming. Just, because this game likes to make a fool of me. Not that I'm complaining. Money's money. Nope. Nope. Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. Next. Okay. That's probably going to be a couple jumps. Yep, two jumps. That's pretty standard. Alright. I bet this is a neutron. Yeah, I gotta keep an eye on my fuel. We're good on fuel for now. Gas giant, huh? Yeah. Yeah, okay, I had a feeling I'd run into another neutron star. I gotta love that.
Warning. Frameshift drive operating beyond safety limit.
right. Wow, 33 orbital bodies. High metal content. Gas giants. I'm not too worried about this. All right, we'll just kind of take a look at what... Take a quick glance at what we've got. Yeah, whatever. Oh, wow, we're, like, going into the nebula. That's pretty cool. All right, this is the one that's, like, 7 jumps. Oh, 5. Okay, we must hit a neutron star halfway through. Yep, and there's the nebula we're going to be hitting. It's just off the port side of the ship. Right there, where I'm looking. It's beautiful colors of red, orange. What did you make? K-type star. Cool. Look at that. Already making discoveries. Get some fuel pretty soon. Hopefully we've got a this next system coming up, we'll have a fuel star. Oh, there's the Skull Nebula, or what I've called the Skull Nebula. Goodbye, Skull Nebula. Perfect. This looks like a star I can scoop, maybe. Yes. You are scoopable. Perfect. Nothing here. Oh, well. Whoa, don't want to get too close. Oh, yeah. ship cool down a little bit. Cool. Got a full happy tank. I'm good with that. Ooh, frameshift drive sitting at 84%. I should be fine. Oh, good. Another star I can scoop. Perfect. All right. Let's get you in there. Got some gas giants. Yeah, I'm not interested in that. Nothing against gas giants. I'm just trying to save my time. Oh, there's a Skull Nebula again. So we haven't quite left its view. I think it looks like a skull anyway. Got the two eye sockets. It's missing a lower jaw, but it definitely looks like a human skull. I mean, I guess it could be a monkey skull. Oh, well. It's a skull, damn it. Okay. Fuel scooping. System scan complete. Alright. This looks like a bunch of planets here. Ooh, what did I discover? T-type star. Cool. Well, look at me, just making all kinds of discoveries. Well, for me anyway. The codex. What's interesting about the codex is, so you can be the first to discover something in a region, and then once you do that, it'll show up in the codex for other people, and they can discover other objects like that, or the same object, I guess. I don't know. It's one of those. There's a lot. So the more I play this game, the more I realize there's several underutilized features in this game, or just things that the devs just kind of abandoned. Codex is one of them. Yeah. Come on. There you go. Supercharged. All right. I think this will be our last waypoint for today, anyway. Oh wow! Look, you can see we're actually in the nebula. That's really cool. Yeah, that's like one jump. What? 20 light years? Are you kidding me? I didn't need to charge. I didn't need to supercharge my FSD for 20 light years. You gotta be kidding me. Whatever. Okay, so the route plotter I used wasn't the best. Apparently, there's little mistakes like that. All right. Hopefully, this is an inhabited system and it's not just like a mega ship sitting. I mean, I'll take a mega ship too, I guess. Whoa, hello there, Star. First things first. Yep, we got a nav beacon. So let's go and scan the nav beacon. Yeah, nav beacons are just those things you take for granted in civilized space. Civilized space. Yeah, I guess civilized space would be correct. Populated space. How about that one? Populated space. I got a smudge on my glasses. Not my headset, my actual glasses, so... That makes things interesting. All right. What the hell is that? Oh, that looks like a, Keelback. Little turtle ship. Ah, there's the nav beacon. All right. While that's scanning, let me fix this. Alright, so one thing you have to learn about VR is if you wear glasses, like me, any smudge, Echo Colonial, ooh, spaceport, there we go. Huh. I wonder, are these, oh my god, these are fleet carriers. You know what? Let's go check out a fleet carrier. I've not had a chance to see these new fleet carriers yet. Well, not in-game. I've seen plenty of them. I've seen plenty of fleet carriers on videos and stuff, but I've never had a chance to actually see one in person. Echo Colonia. Let's see, what kind of info can we get about this little guy? Owner, squadron, Echo. Echo's the squadron. Expected to arrive in 6 minutes. Docking access all. Notorious docking access allowed. Has appropriate landing pads, yes. Cool. Echo Squadron. So, Squadron's basically a guild in the game. Unfortunately, ooh, what'd I find? Standard gas giant? Okay, cool. Rocky planet with no atmosphere. Well, those are like a dime a dozen, but okay, sure, whatever. Ooh, look at those rings. That is wild. Actually, let me try to steer away from this planet. I should have plotted a better course. Sometimes the shortest point, no, the fastest route between two points is not always a straight line. Because if it pulls you through a gravity well, yeah, not helpful. Okay, let's see here. We're good. Alright, throttle good. Now we just have to wait for us to get close enough. Come on. We're almost there. Okay, it's 9 kilometers ahead. I want to check something real quick. This thing's got trade. Friendly, huh? Oh, the Colonial Council. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so we're apparently like 9 kilometers away. It should be coming into view soon. Oh. Okay. I guess when it said expected arrival 6 minutes, it hasn't arrived yet. Alright. No departure planned. Okay, so there's actually another one. Okay, that one hasn't arrived yet. So, I think these fleet carriers have a jump range of like it's either 500 light years or 5,000 light years. I think it's 500 light years. But, I don't know. They're basically a money pit at this point. A little too close to that. basically, they're a money pit at this point. But, I don't know. Oh, shit. I need to slow down. Here we go. That's a fleet carrier. Well, it's upside down. There we go. That's a fleet carrier. That is owned by another player. It is owned by Commander Acastus. I don't know. He's of the Hull Seals Squadron. Docking access. So we could dock on it if we wanted to. Well, let's see here. Search and rescue. But see, the problem is I don't know if... he's going to have the services I need. And plus, I'm building up reputation with the Colonial Council, so I don't want to sell my data to him because I probably won't get rep. But yeah, we're currently kind of on the bottom of this. Yep, that's 5 billion credits to own one of these. And that's just to own it. There's also like a weekly maintenance cost associated with it as well. Let's this isn't really a good view. You can't really see much. But yeah, those are the... those are the landing pads. So you just request permission like you normally do, and you can land on it. They're currently indestructible. Damn, look at the size of those drive engines, though.
Woo.
I mean, it certainly looks like it costs $5 billion, that's for sure. I mean, you can scan me all you want. I don't have anything. All right. Let's do one last flyby. Loitering infraction. All right, cool. That was fun. Nah. All right, let's get out of mass lock and land on a planet. Well, not land on a planet. Let's hit up the spaceport. Ooh, is that actually on the planet? Cool, I guess. Yep, it's actually on the planet. Okay, cool. Well, I guess. We'll be going this way. I'm trying out something different. There we go. Well, cool. We got to see a fleet. That was pretty exciting. Like I said, right now, they're just not worth it. At least, I haven't seen any, like, valid use cases for it. Well, not valid. I hate games that... feel like a second job. Like, I mean, the fact... it brings me back to Star Wars Galaxies. Anyone remember Star Wars Galaxies? Came out, like, 2003. Like, I remember there was a mechanic there where players could basically, like, start their own cities. And, you know, you had to pay, like, a weekly maintenance on your buildings. And if you were, like, within city limits... you had to, like, pay taxes. I'm like, oh my god, this is too much like real life, man. And I think that's where Blizzard got it right. Like, they made World of Warcraft, at least in its initial run, they made World of Warcraft, you know, where it was fun. You didn't have to worry about, like, maintenance upkeep on your buildings and paying taxes. That's a little too much. That was a little too much realism in my games for me. Alright. Okay, we should be jumping. Yeah, we should be jumping out of glide pretty soon. Yeah. I actually executed that glide very nicely. I'm getting better at this. I am very welcome at this terrestrial port. Look at that. I am very welcome. The Colonial Council loves me, guys. That's exciting. All right. I think we're at the right point where I can request landing. Yeah, where the hell is it? There we go. Request approved. Cleared for landing on docking bay 08. I'm a delight. But yeah, this little outpost sits roughly halfway between Seoul and the Colonia region. Well, landing gear deployed. Nice and easy. Little up a little bit. Contact. Repair. Refuel. Alright. Let me all snug in my port. All right. Let's do a few advanced maintenance. Ship integrity, 94%. All right, go ahead and fix that up. I'm worried a little bit because once I get out to Beagle Point, I'm not going to be able to repair my ship's integrity. Hope my ship just doesn't, like, fall apart on me. We'll find out, right? All right. Sixteen million's coming to mind. Okay, so there's 5 million. Ah, you've earned the following acolytes. First to discover. Cool, I found something. Okay. Okay, I aimed a little too high on that one, but 5,000's good. 5 million. 5,000, what am I thinking? Ooh, am I... I am now an ally of the Colonia Council. Very nice. I'm going to need that rep when I actually get to Colonia. So, all right. So we are just past the halfway point. Let's take a look. I didn't want this map. I wanted the galaxy map. There we go. All right. So let's see. There's Colonia. Okay, so Colonia is 10,000 light years away. All right. And Seoul should be like a little bit over that. Alphabetical order. It's at the bottom. Seoul. 11,797. So like 11,11.8K. So yeah, we're halfway there. So, this week, I'm probably going to make some progress. I want to try to make it to the 3/4 mark before the next video, but we'll see. I mean, like I said, it's a journey, right? It's not the destination. Anyway, I want to thank all of you for watching. If you follow me at Twitter, that's at RedFalcon2K6, you will get updates on any schedule changes to the stream, as well as... Well, mostly it's just stuff about the stream. But if there's anything worth sharing, it's going to be on there. All these videos are also archived on my YouTube channel. There's a link to that in somewhere on Twitch. What else? I think that's it for now. I want to thank all you folks for watching, and be safe out there.